I mean, Modern Warfare 4 is all but confirmed at this point, if you ask me, and most people seem to be talking about what's wrong with Call of Duty right now, myself included, from time to time, and there's definitely a lot wrong with it, but I thought it would be fun to switch it up. Let's make this video all about positive memories and going down memory lane and checking out the previous Modern Warfare games to find some things that could be brought into the next game to give it that Modern Warfare feel, if that's what you're wanting. What is up, everybody? Chaos here, and these are going to be my 10 picks for the guns in Modern Warfare history that I think should make a return if it ends up being Modern Warfare 4. So be sure to let me know if I missed one of your favorite guns, and here we go. Do me a quick favor, everybody. If you enjoy the content, make sure you drop a like, make sure you're subscribed to the channel, and turn on those post notifications. Ring that little bell so you get a notification whenever a new Chaos video goes live, so you can get the ever so important first comment. The AK-47. Let's kick it off with an iconic firearm that made its Call of Duty debut all the way back in COD 4. Then it was brought back in Modern Warfare 2 and Modern Warfare 3. It has the trifecta for the Modern Warfare trilogy, making it one of the few weapons that has actually appeared in every single game. It is tried and true, slow firing but hard hitting, and it's pretty harsh with the recoil sometimes, but you get used to it. Now, the COD 4 version was definitely the best. The Modern Warfare 2 and Modern Warfare 3 versions were still viable options and fun to use, and I think Infinity Ward would be nuts if they didn't bring the AK back for Modern Warfare 4 to make it 4 in a row. Like I said, it's only one of few guns that has been in every Modern Warfare game so far, so you have to keep that legacy going. The Spaz 12, this fan favorite shotgun, if you weren't on the other end of the barrel, first appeared in Modern Warfare 2, where it was most famously used by none other than Sandy Ravage. And if you have not seen his old Modern Warfare 2 Spaz montages, go back, watch them in all their 720p glory, and educate yourself. The Spaz was brought back in Modern Warfare 3, although it was nerfed a bit due to it was a primary weapon as opposed to a secondary. That's right, shotguns were secondaries in Modern Warfare 2. Then it was even brought back in Infinite Warfare as a classic weapon called the S-Ravage, as a little tribute to Sandy, which is one of the coolest things I've ever seen from a AAA development team. So when's the last time you saw a franchise of Call of Duty's level making a call out that big to a community member? Shotguns are pretty annoying in Call of Duty nowadays due to people's tendencies to spam the semi-auto ones, but the Spaz 12, it was pretty well balanced if you ask me, and it should definitely make a comeback. And you're saying well balanced, it was overpowered. The ACR. It first appeared in Modern Warfare 2, where it was hands down one of the best, if not the best gun in the game. Then it was brought back in Modern Warfare 3, where once again, one of the best, if not the best, guns in the game, although it wasn't quite as overpowered this time around, it was still a beast. The ACR is a pretty fast-firing, low-recoil weapon that will kill in 3 to 5 shots. The Modern Warfare 2 version, in particular, was ridiculous because it had no recoil. It made it super easy to cross-map people, and the Modern Warfare 3 ACR wasn't quite as ridiculous, but if you played MW3 at all, I'm sure you saw dozens, if not hundreds, of people running around with the ACR with a suppressor and extended mags. This baby was one of the most iconic Modern Warfare guns of all time, and there's no way that it doesn't make a return to the Modern Warfare weapon roster if that's the game we get. Let's get some sniper love in here. The Barrett 50 Cal. The sniper is another one of the few weapons that has been in every Modern Warfare game so far, and it's been a high-tier weapon in almost all of them. The COD 4 Barrett was arguably the best sniper in the game due to the insane damage and the high fire rate cap. Then it returned in MW2, the game where everything was busted in one way or another, and it was still a top-tier sniper. If you were quickscoping in Modern Warfare 2, you were either using Intervention or the Barrett 50 Cal. And then we go to MW3. It was nerfed a little bit in an attempt to put more emphasis on the bolt-action snipers, but it was still a very good weapon to use and was great for constant pressure from range and objective modes. Just like the AK, the Barrett should get a spot on the Modern Warfare roster just for the legacy element alone, but also because it's a fan favorite weapon and it's been almost 8 years since we got to use it in a COD game. Let's stick with the sniper tradition at number 6. MSR. That's right. Speaking of snipers, this was the ultimate Modern Warfare 3 quick scoping weapon. The MSR was like an updated version of the Modern Warfare 2 Intervention, but with a much thicker firing sound. Who here, raise your hand if you have memories of running around in MW3 with the MSR, quick scoping, or just playing aggressive, getting your specialist streak, and then being that super soldier that was running around with this awesome sounding sniper. The MSR was to Modern Warfare 3 what the Intervention was to MW2. And I personally, for the sniper's sake, would love to see it come back. The Model 1887. Let's talk about legacies in COD for a second. This was added to COD in Modern Warfare 2, where it was, of course, famously broken at launch and somehow had seemingly infinite range. Did you get to experience this pre-patch? It allowed you to use the Makimbo and just snipe people from across the map. And I don't exaggerate that, people. Go back and watch some old videos, and that's exactly what you do. You have a shotgun in your hand. You actually have two shotguns in your hand, and you snipe people. The models were brought back in Modern Warfare 3, but they were hit hard with nerfs, and you can only use one at a time. But then in Infinite Warfare, they brought back a second time complete with the Akimbo option. The Model 1887s are some of the most iconic shotguns in COD history, right up there with the Spaz. And if you ask me, Infinity Ward should definitely bring them back for Modern Warfare 4 with the option to dual-wield them with that awesome reload animation that makes you feel like you're the Terminator himself. And heck, if they want to, bring them back for just one day at the beginning of launch in the same broken state they were in Modern Warfare 2. Let everybody experience the sniper shotgun phenomenon that was the Model 1887, and then patch it. The MP7, this is low-key one of my favorite SMGs. I don't say that much, but it actually is. It's only appeared in one Modern Warfare game, but it made such a huge splash on that game that it's now considered one of the best guns in COD history. It was one of the very last weapons you unlocked in MW3, and it was hands down one of the most used guns in the game due to it being blatantly overpowered. It hit super hard. It had great range. It fired quickly and virtually had no recoil. While I don't think the MP7 should just be a copy-paste from Modern Warfare 3 into MW4 because then it would just be overpowered again, I absolutely think it should make another appearance. After all, the MP7 has been getting a lot more attention in other first-person shooter games like CSGO, Battlefield, Rainbow Six, and many more, and it's becoming one of those modern weapons that you kind of just expect to see in modern military video games. So why not bring it back? Just make sure that it's balanced a little better this time. The UMP-45, the unsung hero. This was the go-to SMG for a lot of people in Modern Warfare 2, and it was one of your starting weapons in MW3. It was the version in Modern Warfare 2 was ridiculous. It had insane damage with ridiculous range, allowing you to three-shot people from across the map if you had good aim, and it was nerfed a little bit in MW3, like a lot of the guns were, but it was still a popular SMG thanks to it being that slow-firing but hard-hitting SMG that we kind of expect to see in Call of Duty games. Every COD game has at least one SMG that fits that description, and we know that Modern Warfare 4 will have one too. So why not bring back the UMP to fit that bill? And then, if you really want to win some people over, just copy-paste the Modern Warfare 2 suppressed UMP firing sound right into the new game, and trust me, you will make everybody happy. The UMP suppressed in Modern Warfare 2, it flew under the radar, but the ones that used it knew how good it was. The Desert Eagle, another one of the few guns that has been in every Modern Warfare game up to date. This had a pretty big fall from grace, though. It was easily the best pistol in COD 4, and it was still a top contender in Modern Warfare 2, but it was destroyed in Modern Warfare 3, and it was arguably one of the worst guns in the game due to its inability to keep up with the amount of SMGs and auto pistols in there, as well as the removal of stopping power. The Deagle deserves to make a comeback, and after it got some love in Modern Warfare Remastered, I think the time is right to bring it back into its glory. Just make sure that you don't butcher the firing sound this time like you did in Modern Warfare 3. Seriously, what happened to the Deagle's firing sound in that game? And maybe take away a little bit of the recoil so when you shoot that first shot, you're not directly looking up at the moon. And at number one today, the Intervention. Despite only being in one Modern Warfare game, this thing, it made such a huge impact on the COD series and the first-person shooter genre as a whole. It's pretty much single-handedly, it gave birth to the quickscoping and trickshotting scene on YouTube. The Intervention was the one and only bolt action in MW2, and there were probably thousands of montages uploaded to YouTube with this thing. The weapon was so popular that it was brought back in Modern Warfare Remastered as a DLC gun called the S-TAC Aggressor, where it once again became one of the most used snipers in the game, just like it was in MW2. If Infinity Ward really wants to win people back to their side with MW4, and they want to put this series back on the right part of the map in a big way, they should 100%. Bring the Intervention back, complete with the Modern Warfare 2 firing sound. Don't get cute with it. Don't bring some audio guy in to make it even better. Just go find that old file, bring it over, and use it. And there you have it, my friends. Those are 10 guns from the Modern Warfare trilogy that I think should be in Modern Warfare 4 if that's the game we get. You guys, let me know if you agree or disagree. If we missed one, let me know what it is in the comment section, and I'll see you guys soon.